Why don't we see anything like this? Welcome back, and a very happy new year to all the viewers, which in the language of physics is C upon lambda. I hope you've liked my videos. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe now. Remember me? I'm Scientify's brother, Dumbify. Scientify has finally chosen an interesting topic for his video. How many aliens are there in the galaxy? I know there are at least two intelligent species in the galaxy.
The second one is my brother.
I can hear you. While we are still debating if aliens exist, a hot-headed scientist even came up with a formula to estimate the number of aliens in the galaxy. Weird? Yes, I also think so, but let's have a look. Let's try to come up with an equation ourselves first. To do this, we need to consider all the factors which affect the presence of alien life. First, let's narrow down our search parameters to only search for intelligent alien life. The number of such civilizations would depend on the rate of star formation in the galaxy. Well, because stars keep life on planets alive just like you get warmth from the sun. At least that's what we think. And that brings us on to the next factor, which is the need for planets to harbor life. We can multiply the rate of star formation by the fraction of stars which have planets around them. Right now, our equation represents the number of stars around which planets exist. Since stars with planets revolving around them make solar systems, we can multiply this number by the fraction of planets per solar system which are capable of sustaining life. Get too close to a star and it will get too hot. Get too far away and you'll freeze to death. The ideal region between these two death chambers is called the Goldilocks Zone. We also need to incorporate the success rate of planets in actually developing life. So we have the number of planets on which life actually develops. What else? Let's go back to the question we were trying to answer. You talked about intelligent life, right?
Oh, right.
Is the factor for being intelligent? We only care about intelligent life. So let's reduce our last factor by multiplying it by the number of planets on which intelligent life emerges. If we also include the factors for aliens communicating using radio waves and the time for which these signals are released, we obtain an equation which is known as Drake's equation. It was given way back in 1961 by someone named Drake. Not this one. Yeah, this is the one I'm talking about. I'm talking about the scientist, not the rapper. Anyway, the Drake equation is a probabilistic argument used to estimate the number of active communicative extraterrestrial civilizations in the universe. Let's try to make sense of the equation. First, let's remove the last two variables. Well, because they're pretty useless and uncertain. And we can multiply the equation by the time for which the civilizations stay alive. Unit check, it's in civilization, so we are all good. We have the values for some of these variables. The rate of star formation is 7 stars per year. Pretty much all stars have planets, so this figure right here should be 1. But only about 0.4 planets per solar system lie in the habitable zone. Plugging in those numbers, our equation looks like this. Now we know nothing about these numbers. Those numbers could be anything. Let's go with a moderate viewpoint. Let's say about a third of the planets develop life, but only 1,000th develop intelligent life. And we could say civilizations last for approximately 500,000 years. Plug in those numbers and you get the number of intelligent alien species in the entire universe as, drumroll,
450!
In a galaxy far, far away, fighting would the Jedi's be to save the universe.
Wait. How is that a moderate viewpoint? Life should develop on at least half of the habitable planets. And at least half of the life is intelligent. Well, the chimpanzee is smarter than me.
And civilization lasts for millions of years.
Whatever. If we plug in those numbers, we get 700,000 civilizations in the universe. See the problem with the equation? It is throwing a very wide range of results, all of which may be incorrect. This is because most of the variables in the equation are very uncertain. Think, while everything with numbers will look fancifully brilliant, we need to interrogate every number, and like that, many equations, like the Drake's equation, will fall flat. Unfortunately, we are still not a shade more informed about aliens.
Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe.